Because of our caring partners, New Life Evangelistic Center is directly helping the homeless as well as taking steps to prevent homelessness. Be sure you stay tuned. I'm Larry Rice, and this is Here's Help. So many homeless people come into New Life Evangelistic Center. Our teams are finding them as they're going out to the highways and the byways on a regular basis. They're coming into the day center, the New Life Evangelistic Center, regularly referred to as the Veterans Coming Home Center. People that are hurting are getting direct help because of faithful partners like you. If you haven't got involved in the work of New Life Evangelistic Center, please do it now. Your much needed gift is absolutely essential. It's New Life Evangelistic Center, P.O. Box 473, St. Louis, Missouri, that's 63166. We have individuals of all different ages coming to us. Let's go to Mark.
We get all kinds of people here, up to 150, sometimes 200 a day, and from different ages. I'm talking to Sharif, who's probably one of the youngest people here. You're 19?
Yes, of course.
Okay, and you're homeless?
Yes.
Tell me how you became homeless.
Well, I got kicked out of my granny's about a month ago, and it's been like this since.
Okay. So why did she kick you out?
She kicked me out because she was abusive and couldn't handle the pressure.
Okay. You're sleeping on the streets right now?
Yes.
Okay. How does that feel to you? What experience are you going through?
It's rough.
Okay. Did you imagine it would be this rough?
Yes, I did.
Okay. How do you handle this?
Well, I just go through it every day, do like I used to do, just be there for the streets, help it out, live on it, breathe on it.
Okay. Does living on the streets depress you?
A little bit.
Are you depressed now?
Yeah.
Okay.
Might as well.
All right. We don't normally get individuals as young as you are, but I'm glad we're here. I'm glad these doors are open. I'm glad we're able to give you a meal, that we can open the free store up, that we can give you a shower and wash your clothes, that we give you a place to rest.
Right.
Right. I saw you on the couch earlier. You were resting.
Yes, I was.
Okay. Is it hard to sleep at night?
A little bit.
Okay. Do you feel safe here?
Yeah. Yeah, it's a pretty safe place, safer than most.
Okay. So we mentioned that you are trying to get off the streets.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. What are you doing to try to get off the streets?
Well, I'm going to OTC. I got apartments planned for me. I got my SSI coming through. Got a couple other opportunities, Pastor.
Okay. So this is temporary for you,
yeah,
right?
It's just a bump in the road.
Okay.
It's nothing major.
All right. What do you think of Jesus?
Jesus is great.
Okay.
We were talking about Jesus the other day.
Yes, we were.
Yes, we were.
All right. Okay, so I'm going to keep you in prayer. You asked me for a backpack, and this is the one that I have left.
Yes, of
course. Right? And you appreciated this. You said it's a nice backpack.
It's a really good backpack.
Right? Okay. So we're going to give you this backpack. We're going to keep Sharif in prayer so that at this young age he finds Christ, and Christ can make a home in his heart, so he's no longer homeless. So don't give up, right? Keep fighting and keep praying to God.
Yes, sir. Amen.
Amen.
Young people, women, so many that are hurting, many veterans, many that aren't veterans, except veterans of the street. And it's the New Life Evangelistic Center they come to, and it's called the Veterans Coming Home Center. So many people, day after day after day. How we need a place like that in St. Louis. And we've seen such a direct disobedience to the law that says that cities can't develop code procedures to stop churches. When we saw the Board of Building Appeals do a few weeks ago, it was nothing further than just being horrendous, total violation of federal law by totally ignoring New Life Evangelistic Center's architectural plans, ignoring all that has been done, and just simply saying, no, we're not going to permit that church to come along. Because we think it's going to end up being a shelter. Well, we have to block off the floor between second and third so people don't go upstairs. There's a place to be for homeless people during the day, from which at the evenings we try to then get them placed at different shelters. But they slammed the door. We're not going to give up. We're going to continue to keep knocking on the door. We're going to continue to encourage people to call the Department of Justice to investigate the violation of the religious rights of the homeless. Just because they're homeless doesn't mean they shouldn't have a right to go to church. Well, they do in Springfield. At 806 North Jefferson in Springfield, it's helping so many men and women, children, but a lot of women coming in. A lot of women are hurting, like Corey.
They say it's not over until it's over. And I always say it's not over until God says it's over. But we still have individuals that are suffering from COVID. Not necessarily catching COVID, but I'm joined here with Corey, and COVID devastated you.
Yeah, lost everything.
Okay. Did you catch the COVID?
I caught COVID, and I got really sick. Mm-hmm. And my guy ended up losing his job because he had to quarantine because he was working for private people, wasn't a company or anything.
Okay.
And they just let him go because he couldn't come to work. And just, we lost everything. And it's hard to get back what you've lost when you've lost it.
Yeah. It is hard to reestablish yourself again.
It is.
Right. How has this place helped you?
It's somewhere I can go and I know I'm going to get a meal and some much needed sleep if I need it. And I am so grateful for that.
Right. Why? I know it's hard because you're sleeping on the streets. Mm-hmm. Right. You asked for me a sleeping bag. Right. How is sleeping on the streets? Because you mentioned coming here is sleeping. So you can't really sleep. You're not getting much sleep, are you?
You're always sleeping with one eye open. Okay. Even if, I mean, if you're not getting runoff, somebody's coming through wherever you're sleeping.
Right.
And it's just, I don't know. I don't sleep well outside anyway.
There's so much hostility against the homeless, right?
They hate us.
Okay.
I think they're scared of us.
Okay. Why do you think they hate you?
It may not be hate. I really think it's fear, you know, because
okay.
I fly a sign sometimes, and when I'm in a certain kind of mood, I usually, you know, sign will say, before you laugh, point and stare, just know this could be you.
Yeah.
Because God giveth and God taketh away.
Yeah.
It could happen just in an instant. Right.
By the grace of God, there go I.
Yeah.
Right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so we're going to bless you with a sleeping bag today. We want to thank you. Corey is also one of the people that help us clean this place up at night. Where you get those who are homeless brothers and sisters to help us clean the place up so we can reopen it tomorrow. And I want to thank you for volunteering.
Oh, no problem. My guy catches the bus for work in the morning, and that's just ensures that...
Right, because we give you a bus ticket?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Absolutely.
All right. I'm praying for you to be restored, right? The Bible says that God will restore you seven times of what you lost. Where Satan has taken away, the destroyer, the accuser of the brother, the one who's come to kill, steal, and destroy. So I want to encourage you to continue having hope.
People say that, you know, I need to have more faith in God, and I tell people that God is my strength. Mm-hmm. He's the only reason I pray all the time.
Okay.
I believe he hears me because when you lose everything, you're grateful for the little things.
That is true. That is so true. Yeah. Thank you, Corey, for being here today.
Thank you.
New Life Evangelistic Center is constantly working to help break the cycle of homelessness. For the women, it's the safe houses that we have, the training center at 2428 Woodson Road in Overland, Missouri. Homeless men have an opportunity to go to the training center in New Bloomfield, Missouri, and from there, go to Springfield to help out and work there, perhaps to St. Louis or other locations. The New Life Evangelistic Center is working to be there when people are hurting. Caleb is one of those individuals that was homeless, came in for training at New Life, and now he's reaching out and helping other homeless individuals. And this is all possible because those that are going to God in earnest prayer, and New Life Evangelistic Center needs your prayers at this time. We do not receive a city, state, or federal dollars like so many agencies do, but it's God's people moving forth by faith, becoming a part of the mighty work that God is doing at this time. You can get involved by sharing those gifts with New Life Evangelistic Center, P.O. Box 473, St. Louis, Missouri, that's 63166. You can help many be set free from the cycle of homelessness like Caleb.
I'm joined here with Caleb, and Caleb, you have joined the New Life Residential Training Program.
Yes, Pastor.
Okay. How's it been for you?
Okay, great.
You were in New Bloomfield for the first.
Yes, Pastor.
Right? And they asked you to come here. right?
Yes,
and you knew the challenges here.
Yes,
right? Are you being challenged?
Yes, Pastor.
But you're holding on to God, right? Mm-hmm. Paul says, I press forward, right, to get the mark of Jesus Christ, to win that crown, right? And you've had to push forward.
Yes, Pastor.
Right? Not looking back.
Yes, Pastor.
Right? And so you also were a veteran.
Yes, Pastor.
Okay. Where did you serve? What unit?
F Company, what, 13, U.S. Army.
Okay. I want to thank you for your service.
Thank you.
But I also want to thank you for your service to our King here, right? Has it been, we mentioned about challenging. What's been challenging for you here?
Just working with with all the new residents and the staff and not getting so overwhelmed that, walking up and asking for help at the same time.
Yeah. You have a demeanor of peace and calmness, right? I think that I believe is God given to you to help you, with the challenges here.
Yes, Pastor.
Okay. So I want to thank you for being here. I want to thank you for dedicating your life to Jesus Christ. And if you're interested in the training program, call me at, let's see, remember my number, 417-866-3363, 417-866-3363. And we can talk about the training program. You would recommend somebody to come to the training program?
Yes, sir.
Okay. It benefited you?
Yes, sir.
Okay. I want to thank you. And again, that number is 417-866-3363. If you know someone who wants to get off the streets and join our program, we're more than happy to talk to them and possibly get them off the streets so they can find a new home and have Jesus make a home in their hearts. So I want to thank you.
Thank you.
Caleb is just one example of many who are experiencing a new life because of all of you that are praying for New Life Evangelistic Center. What a blessing you are in the lives of the hurting and homeless, those that are caught in that trap or the cycle of homelessness. New Life Evangelistic Center is continuing to reach out through the love of Christ to help them to break that cycle, to give them a new beginning. And it's happening over and over. Now, one big area that we urgently need prayer for, we need a financial miracle for, is to help so many people that aren't able to pay their rent right now. Rent costs are skyrocketing. And they're making it day by day, but continue to trust God, looking to Him. And that's how we have to do it here. And oh, I thank God for the miracles that we see right at the nick of time. And maybe you're facing a critical need at this moment. Call upon the Lord in the day of trouble. He will hear you and deliver you. It's a fact. Jesus has promised, and He meant it when He said, I will never leave you nor forsake you. And in John 14:12, when He says, behold, I tell you the truth, if you believe in me, you can do the very works I do. Yes, even greater things, because I'm going to the Father. Whatever He asks the Father in my name, I will do it. Maybe you're struggling like one man I talked to today. Really struggling. Anxiety is about to swallow him up. He saw these bills. He knew what to do. And then he's telling me about that. And I shared with him from Philippians 4. I said, be anxious for nothing, but everything with prayer and supplication with thanksgiving. Let your requests be made known to God. And the peace of God that passes all understanding shall be yours in Christ Jesus. As that man did that, he did a mighty miracle also and met many needs. God is a miracle-working God. He's always right on time. Maybe not my time schedule, your time schedule, but He's on time, all right. And there are many that need help, many need prayer, many that need New Life Evangelistic Center to step out and help them at this time. And we need you to pray for us. We need a financial miracle. And your gift, no matter how small, whatever amount, will make a big difference, be an answer to a lot of people's prayers. It's P.O. Box 473, St. Louis, Missouri, that's 63166. I want to go to Chris Aaron at this time, and he's going to talk to some of those people. Some of the people that need help right now. Some people are on the verge of homeless. They're not homeless yet, but if they don't get help with the rent, they could be. So please pray for these individuals. Please pray for New Life Evangelistic Center so we can be there when the people are hurting. How I thank God for each one of you faithful partners that are doing just that.
My name is Pastor Chris Aaron Rice, and there are so many people who really need assistance with rent or with their mortgage. Right now, our country is going through economic hardship in many different ways. And there are so many people who have fallen onto hard times. They've had one thing happen in their life, which has then snowballed into really struggling. Well, one of the things that New Life is committed to is being there when people are hurting. And so we're really striving to help people in this way. And the only way we could do that is if we have people like you who are seeing this, seeing the needs, maybe even experiencing the needs, but desiring to help people in need in this particular way. We want to be able to help people who are experiencing hardship in paying their rent or their mortgage. We want to be able to help as many people as possible. But with tens of thousands of people experiencing that need right now here in the St. Louis area, affordable housing is really, really hard to find. And not only that, it just takes one thing to happen and then a snowball effect. And we're going to hear from people who are in this situation where they really need some help. We're going to hear about that right now. So I'm here. What's your first name?
Lauren.
Lauren, tell me a little bit about what's going on in your life right now, and particularly, what are some of the needs that you have?
Well, actually, I currently lost my job due to my car problems, and that caused me to fall behind on my rent assistance and some of my utilities. And basically, I just need help with them until I get a job and get back on my feet.
So you were working, you were trying to make ends meet, and then you had something that's pretty common, a car breaks down. And, you know, how much did the car cost to fix?
Actually, it was probably maybe like $200.
Okay, so not a big issue, but that $200 then pulls from the grocery bill, it pulls from all these other things that, I mean, you weren't expecting that $200 bill, right?
Right.
And then that slowly builds up into, well, I'm falling behind in my rent.
My rent, my utilities.
Yeah. But the big critical thing is the job. You were working and then you couldn't get that income coming in. If you lose a job, I mean, it makes it really difficult, and you've lost a job and transportation for some time. So what keeps you going? What keeps you putting one foot in front of the other?
I just take it one step at a time and try to find like resources that can help me and just go day by day.
And, I mean, it's really hard to do that sometimes, especially when it seems like it's raining down problems, right?
Yeah.
I mean, we're a Christian ministry. We're a Christian organization. We want you to know that even in the midst of the hardship, the things that you're struggling with, God does love you. And we're able to help because the church is really being the church. The church is stepping into the needs and physically helping other people. In James, we read, faith without works is dead, right? And the church is stepping in and serving you practically in this way. And we just don't want you to miss the fact that this is really the only way we're able to help you is because Christ is the Redeemer, and because other people out there who are watching or are supporting New Life are coming alongside you. How does that make you feel?
I like it. I'm glad there's someone out here that can help us when we are in the need.
And particularly, I mean, the only reason that again, we can help is because people do care. They care about your needs. They care about the needs of other people. And they care because they've been cared for as well by God. And so we are thankful that we're able to help you, Lauren, and we've helped you in just a tangible way, witnessing the love of Christ. And we hope that you know that there is hope to break out of this hardship that you're experiencing right now, and that better times are coming. What kind of jobs have you had in the past, and what kind of jobs are you looking for?
Actually, I was just in fast food, but I worked in housekeeping, fast food, cashier, retail. I worked quite a few jobs in a lot of different fields.
So are you optimistic that you're going to be able to find a job here pretty quickly?
Yes, I think so.
Well, Lauren, thanks for talking with me today, and you have a great day, okay?
You too. Thank you.
I'm here with another. What's your first name?
Tanisha.
Okay, and tell me a little bit about what's going on in your life right now and why you are in need.
Well, I have a job, but I'm living alone, and I have so many bills. It's only me paying them, so I'm reaching out for help, and I'm taking advantage of it if I can.
So you've got a lot of different bills that are going on. Is it hard to keep track of all of them?
Yes, it is. It's hard doing it by yourself.
Yeah. It is really difficult, and there's very little affordable housing. So what are some of the things that have kind of led to you slipping behind a little bit?
City.
Like, how have we fallen behind a little bit? What are some of the things that have happened?
Well, first I tried to pray and leave it in God's hands, but I also tried to seek out for help. Once again, I try to seek out for help. I just Google a lot of different places. I ask family members, do they know anything? And that's how I get it.
So first you prayed about it. How important is prayer in your life?
It's very important. God is real. He's real. I believe in him.
And so you're trying to faithfully just live and work and do your best. But that can be challenging sometimes. We fall on hard times.
Yes. It's very challenging, but I stay above water. And like I said, I just pray and go from there.
You know that God loves you.
Yeah.
And even in slipping behind, you're seeing God's love in the other people who are coming alongside you and helping you.
Yes.
What would you say to people who, I mean, they just don't know the need, they've never really experienced the need that you're in right now, how would you encourage them to get involved?
I would just say, try your best, do your best, and as long as you put one forward, God will lead you the way. He will.
Absolutely. Well, it is so important that we come alongside other people and help serve in really practical ways. We want our faith to be seen and witnessed and felt. And so that's how we're helping. We want you to see this and come alongside us and help even more people. Thank you so much for coming in and talking with us. I'm here with Ariana. Ariana, tell me a little bit about some of the things that are going on in your life right now.
I just started work, but for about 2 months, I was out of work. I was out of a job. I have a son, so I had to act proactively to get some assistance because I'm a teacher assistant. So when the kids were out of school, we didn't get paid for the 2 months that they were out of school. So unfortunately for me, because work stopped doesn't mean bills stopped. So I had to get some help with June and July to pay my rent. So my son's school guardian angel, who is also pays people's rent and stuff like that and assistance to them, they the one that gave me you all's number. And so I just jumped right on it immediately.
So you've been working really hard to kind of shore up the gap between employment and then it just kind of snowballs. It makes it really hard to catch up sometimes, right?
Oh, yeah. And one thing I dislike about it, because I don't like to say hate, is you never know when it's coming. You never know. Life just going to hit you in the face and you just got to deal with it. So, and me being from Chicago, I don't have no family, no friends out here. So I have to make it work with what I have. So
yeah, I was actually born in Chicago too and raised on the north side of the city, and there's a lot of need in Chicago, isn't there?
Absolutely. And it's a need everywhere, actually. But I was grateful to be able to have these resources presented to me while I'm in St. Louis, because I can always go back home, but I'm just trying to make things work the best way I know how out here. So, yeah.
The culture is a little different out here in St. Louis than it is in Chicago.
Okay. So, yeah, it is. It's definitely a culture shock. you know, Chicago is a very, very big city. And when I came here, it was like St. Louis is like really small. So you have to, coming from a big city to a small city, a lot of changes you got to go through, a lot of new people you got to meet. And so, and I've always had a job since I was 16. I've always worked, and I never, ever fell on hard times. I never got behind no rent, never. So when this hit me, I was just like, oh, man. And I kind of shut down. I was like, God, how am I going to do this? And honestly, he been providing a way. So I'm just thankful to God that he was able to put certain resources and people in my life to help me get back on my feet.
And that's the way it works, honestly, is that sometimes nobody can guarantee that their situation now is going to be the same even in a couple of hours. And so we live by that faith, and God does have this way of providing in many different ways. And we're really seeing that play out in the lives of many when they come here. The assistance that we provide just adds to the assistance that they're gathering from other people, other sources. We want to be able to help more, and we want to be able to help more people. But really, the only way is by people like you are watching and saying, you know what, I'm tired of hearing about the need and not doing anything about it. I want to serve people who need that assistance, not just a handout, but really a hand up to help them continue to serve and live and glorify God in a variety of different ways.
Agreed, yep.
Thank you so much for talking with us today, Ariana, and you have a great day.
Thank you so much.
Many people are in need in St. Louis, throughout Missouri, and even throughout the United States. When we see these incredible needs, we have to go to God in prayer, and we have to pray, Lord, fill these needs. But when we make that radical prayer, we better be prepared to be a part of the solution to fill those needs. It's easy to pray that. It's much harder to put that faith in action and really be a part of the change that we want to see in people's lives. James says it this way, what good is it if when a brother who's hungry comes to you and you say, be warm and be fed, and then leave him and walk away instead of supplying his needs, right? Faith without works is dead. We cannot claim that we love Jesus and yet turn a blind eye to all of those who are crying out to him for help. The church needs to be the church. The people of God need to rise up as the people of God and not just say, yes, Jesus is my Lord and Savior. That confession is great, but actually do Jesus is my Lord and Savior. And so we can fill these needs, and we should stop expecting really the government to do what the church was always called to. We should stop expecting the government to do what God ordained the church to do. And when we rise up together, we can do amazing things, but we really need your support right now. New Life Evangelistic Center only relies on people like you to give and to pray and to serve and to volunteer. So please get involved with New Life today. We really cannot do this work without you. The financial needs are really great at this time, but our God is greater. And we stand on faith that God is going to work through people like you to minister to the people like Ariana and others who need to experience Christ's love in tangible ways. Please get involved today. Thank you so much, and God bless.